The U.S. Air Force and Lockheed Martin have provided details regarding the demonstration of the Rapid Dragon air-launched palletized munitions concept, which was carried out recently. Palletized munitions can be crudely referred to as missiles in a box. Viewers may note that for the particular demonstration, surrogate weapons were delivered from the cargo holds of a C-117A Globemaster III strategic transporter and an EC-130J psychological operations PSYOP aircraft. This is a new way to deploy standoff weapons and has significant implications. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. Air Force plans to use air lifters as weapons trucks through the Rapid Dragon program. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The Rapid Dragon program, previously designated the Palletized Munitions Program, is an accelerated research campaign led by the Air Force Strategic Development Planning and Experimentation Office, SDPE, part of the Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL. The goal is to assess the operational utility of delivering large volumes of palletized, long-range strike weapons from military cargo aircraft like C-130. The idea is to use airlifters as a force multiplier. Viewers may note that dedicated transporters have a massive payload capacity. For example, a C-130 can carry up to 42,000 pounds or 19,000 kilogram payload. The program is aiming to use existing airlifters of the U.S. Air Force for carrying and also deploying weapons. The pallets allow cruise missiles to be loaded onto aircraft like the C-130s without modifications. This way, U.S. Air Force can significantly increase the number of long-range weapons it can deploy. Long-range standoff strike weapons are essential when taking on near-peer rivals like China and Russia, which have integrated air defense systems. Standoff weapons like AGM-158B, Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile Extended Range Cruise Missile, or JASSM-ER, enable the U.S. Air Force to carry out attacks without having to enter the rival's strike envelope. This stealthy cruise missile can fly very long ranges and strike high-value targets while keeping the launching aircraft clear of well-defended adversary airspace. For example, JASSM-ER has a publicly stated range of at least 923 kilometers, or around 575 miles. This is also a cheaper option than deploying dedicated bombers, and the palletized system has been designed to be scalable, so small as well as large airlifters could employ it. Airlifters are equipped with rear ramps that can be opened in flight to airdrop cargo pallets. Rapid Dragon program takes this a step further. Lockheed Martin has stated that in the tests, Rapid Dragon munition pallet was dropped from a C-17 and an EC-130J at an operationally relevant altitude. Once released, and these were stabilized by parachutes, the munition pallet released surrogate missiles in quick succession. The missiles drop vertically, deploy their wings, ignite their motors, and fly to their targets. Deep surrogate missiles were aerodynamically identical to the JASM-ER. Well, prima facie, this looks simple. It's not. For this to work correctly, several steps need to be accomplished accurately. A high-altitude airdrop using the modular deployment box, jettison of multiple weapons from the palletized weapon deployment system, and clean separation from the deployment system. An operational aircrew from the 492 Special Operations Training Group Detachment 2 and a test aircrew from the 418th Flight Test Squadron conducted the airdrops. The test was carried out in an operationally relevant environment, demonstrating the feasibility of a palletized delivery of long-range strike weapons. Scott Calloway, Lockheed Martin Advanced Strike Programs Director, said of the tests at White Sands, "These Rapid Dragon deployments represent the first end-to-end demonstration of a palletized strike munition, from rolling missile pallets onto an aircraft to in-flight missile release." Dr. Dean Evans, the Rapid Dragon Program Manager at the Air Force Research Laboratories, AFRL's, Strategic Development Planning and Experimentation Office, SDPE, said in a statement, "This enhanced capability can provide combatant commanders additional targeting flexibility and control in the prosecution of the high-end flight. Additionally, the retargeting methodology used is transferable to other strike platforms, potentially making all JASSM-capable strike assets more lethal in an increasingly complicated and dynamic near-peer conflict." Importantly, Lockheed Martin stated that the personnel on the ground used satellite communication data links to transmit targeting data to the Rapid Dragon system, demonstrating the ability to retarget the missiles while the launch aircraft is airborne. The aircraft agnostic battle management system on board the aircraft received new targeting data and uploaded it to a JASSM-ER emulator. As per the plan, Rapid Dragon program will conduct a live fire test with a production JASSM-ER from a cargo aircraft by the end of 2021. That test data will be used to optimize the system. This could see work on ways to reduce load-reload times, overall ease of operation, to name a few. As per reports, a follow-on program will look at expanding the Rapid Dragon integration to include additional weapon systems. These new capabilities can provide American military commanders additional flexibility when it comes to hitting a large number of targets. Out-of-the-box thinking is critical to meet the challenges posed by rivals, and the Rapid Dragon program showcases that the U.S. military is on the right track. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.